Hello, I'm Jack Puffenberger, current president of the University of Toledo College of Law Alumni Affiliate. It's my pleasure on behalf of our board to welcome you to this, the first and hopefully last, virtual LaPalooza. The purpose of this event is to support the Dean John Stepler Scholarship Fund at the University of Toledo College of Law. For a number of years, our affiliate sponsored a golf outing to support the fund. Last year, the concept of LaPalooza came into being, and we all enjoyed a wonderful and memorable evening at Shorty's Back 40, listening to the music of the Kirbys. Unfortunately, this year, we must meet virtually, but I can assure you that once again, we have great entertainment for your listening pleasure. This event was created entirely by the Law Alumni Affiliate, and I would like to thank Ansley Abrams Frederick and her staff for all the work they put in to put this together. Your contributions to the scholarship fund are vitally important to those students who are striving to join our great profession. You will hear from some of them during the course of the next hour. But for now, the University of Toledo Law Alumni Affiliate proudly presents 2020 Virtual LaPalooza. So kick back and enjoy the wonderful music provided this year by the Arctic Clam duo of Judge Nicole Curry and Scott Biddle. Once again, thank you for joining us, and thank you for your generous contributions to the Dean John Stepler Scholarship Fund. Enjoy.
Hello, everybody. I'm Nicole Curry, and this is Scott Biddle, and together we are the Arctic Clam duo. We are so happy that you joined us tonight for this great cause, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the good time.
You got the dreamer's disease. Age 14, you got me down on my knees. So polite, you're busy still saying please. Friend of me, so when you're down at your friends, every night we smash a Mercedes Benz. First we roll and then we laugh till we cry. I'm coming home, baby, your tops. Give it to me now. 4 a.m., we ran a miracle mile. We're flat broke, but hey, we do it in style. The bad rich got's flying down for your trial. But when the night is falling, you cannot find a friend. You feel this whole damn world will fall apart. You'll be okay. Follow your heart. You're in harm's way. I'm right behind. Now say your mind. The music in you, don't let go. You got the music in you. What a dance left this world is gonna pull through. Don't give up, you got a reason to live. Can't forget, you only get what you give. Don't let go, you got the music in you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You always get what you give. Just don't be afraid to leave. Health insurance rip off artists. AKA big bank is buying. Fake computers crash and dying. Cloning while they're multiplying. Fashion shoots with vacant heads. And gold need love and Marilyn Manson. They're all fakes. Run to your mansions. Come around, we'll kick your ass in. Let's go. Wanna dance left.
Places to run to. Yeah, and if she ever died trying, she had one little promise she was gonna keep. Oh yeah, alright, take it easy baby, may it last all night. She was an American girl. Well, it was kinda cold that night. She stood all alone on the balcony. Well, she could hear the cars roll by way out on 441. Like the waves crashing on the beach. After one desperate moment there, she crept back to her memories. God, it's so painful when something is so close. You're still so far out of reach. Oh yeah, alright, take it easy baby, make it last all night. She was an American girl. Oh, yeah. Thank you. take it easy, baby. Make it last the whole night. She was an American girl. Ooh. Oh, yeah. All right. Take it easy, baby. Make it last the whole night. She was an American girl.
All right, our first speaker of the night is Elizabeth Ellison, a 2016 John W. Stopler Scholarship recipient. She is here to tell you how this scholarship fund impacted her as a law student and why you should consider donating to this year's scholarship fund.
Hello, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Ellison, and I am a graduate of the University of Toledo College of Law, class of 2017, and a John W. Stopler Scholarship Fund recipient. I understand the financial hurdles that students go through in order to get a quality education. I am the first in my family to graduate from college, and when the idea of attending law school crossed my mind, I'd be lying if I say that the cost did not intimidate me. Even throughout college, I always had a job. When I found out that employment would not be possible during the rigor of 1L year, I knew that I would have to rely on student loans. Although this wasn't ideal, I ended up taking the leap and enrolling at the University of Toledo. The funds from the scholarship allowed me to lessen the financial burden in my pursuit of a law degree, and for that, I am forever grateful. I am an associate at the law offices of Aaron D. Cox in Taylor, Michigan, a real estate firm. Currently, I focus on any area of law that real estate touches. I am proud to help my clients just as this scholarship helped me and my education. The impact of this scholarship is immense and is only possible with the generosity of our alumni. So please, donate. Thank you.
Well, hello, everybody. My name is Drew Griffith. What's that? Oh, all right. Hello, everyone. My name is Drew Griffith. I'm a proud alumni of the University of Toledo College of Law, class of 1985. Welcome to the 2020 LaPalooza. This event succeeded the John Stepler Golf Tournament that was held annually since 1990. Last year was our first LaPalooza. Thank you very much for attending this virtual event tonight. My task from the law alumni officials was to create cohesion and energy and to encourage fundraising. So if you will, grab something to write with. The next time you hear from me, I'll encourage you to jot down a website, and we hope that you will support the John W. Stepler Scholarship Fund as you have in the past. And we appreciate hearing from Elizabeth Ellison here right before I came on, sharing her story of how the Stepler Scholarship impacted her and her ability to be a lawyer and go to law school, and that was great. We appreciate hearing from Arctic Clam. They're up next again with, I believe, four songs in a row. It's like a long play FM radio station from back in the 1970s. So Arctic Clam, Judge Jeff Puffenberger, the president of the Alumni Association, we all welcome you. We appreciate your participation. We look forward to your generous giving on this fundraising event. So now just sit back and enjoy a little bit more from Arctic Clam. I think that went pretty good. Thank God I didn't even have to put on pants.
And now more music.
Got my first real six string, bought it at the Five and Dime. Played until my fingers bled. Was the summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Joni got married. Should've known we never get far. Oh, and when I look back now, the summer seemed to last forever. Oh, and if I had your hand, I knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life. Mm-hmm.
Ain't no use in complaining when you know you got a job to do. Spend my evenings down at the old drive-in, and that's when I met you. Standing on your mama's porch, you told me that you'd wait forever. Oh, and if I had the choice, you know I'd always wanna be there. Those were the best days of my life. Oh, yeah. Back in the summer of a 69. Now the times are a-changing. Look at everything that's come and gone. Sometimes when I play my old six string, I think about you and what went wrong. Standing on your mama's porch, you told me that you'd wait forever. Oh, and when I held your hand, you knew that it was now or never. Those were the best days of my life. Summer of a 69. Me and my baby in a 69. Oh, yeah, me and my baby in a 69.
Ah.
I got brass in pocket, got bottle up, I'm gonna use it. Intention, I'm feeling inventive, gonna make you notice. Got motion, restrained motion, I've been driving on Detroit leading, no reason. Just seems so pleasing. Gonna make you notice. Gonna use my arms, gonna use my legs, gonna use my style, gonna use my sidestep, gonna use my fingers, gonna use my imagination. Oh, cause I'm gonna make you see. Nobody like me. Well, I'm special. I'm gonna have some of your intention. Give it to me. I got rhythm, can't miss a beat. Well, I got a new skank so sweet. Intention, I'm winking at you. Gonna make you nutty. Gonna use my arms, gonna use my legs, gonna use my style, gonna use my sidestep, gonna use my fingers, gonna use my imagination. Oh, cause I'm gonna make you see nobody else here, nobody like me. I'm special. I gotta have some of your attention, give it to me, cause I'm gonna make you see nobody else here, nobody like me. I'm special. I'm gonna have some of your attention, give it to me.
Oh,
the lights go down in the city and the sun shines on the bay. Do I wanna be there in my city?
Next up, we have a message and a College of Law update from Dean Barrows.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Law LaPalooza 2020, our event in honor of one of my most distinguished predecessors, John Stepler. I'm pleased to report that the College of Law is thriving, even in these very challenging times. We just welcomed 128 new incoming first-year law students. That's up 82% from the 70 that we welcomed in 2015. Our faculty are doing an amazing job in supporting our students in adapting to the new environment. We have most of our classes online right now. We have some in person, some hybrid. I can tell you from personal experience, because I'm teaching a property section in the auditorium, that it's very odd to teach a bunch of law students when they're all wearing masks. But we're adapting and we're meeting the educational needs of our students. We're also meeting the needs of our students outside the classroom. Our staff is doing a wonderful job. And I can tell you it's been incredibly important to be able to support them through the Eisler Fund. The Eisler Fund is in memory of Beth Eisler, and it's a fund that we use to support our students when they have unusual financial needs. We've been able to support them through alumni gifts to that fund, but also the Access Lex Institute gave us a very generous $25,000 gift to support students in these challenging times. We're very grateful to the Access Lex Institute for giving us that generous gift. We're working with our faculty, staff, and students to address issues of racial equality that have been the forefront in our society in the past several months. We're doing many, many things in that area, but one thing we're doing in particular is we're curating a lecture series. It's kicked off with a lecture by former Toledo Law faculty member David Harris. So we're going to be engaged in that issue throughout the school year and on an ongoing basis. Continuing to support students is incredibly important. I'm so grateful to all the support that the Toledo Law family gives to our students. I especially today ask you to think about giving a gift to the Stepler Fund in memory of John Stepler that supports a scholarship. And that scholarship support in general is really incredibly important to our students. So we're really grateful to the support that you continue to give us and to our community and our students. And I wish you all the well, and it's really good to see you virtually tonight. Take care.
Well, hello again. Drew Griffith, class of 1985 here. Thank you, Dean Barrows, for those inspiring words. I'm sure it was almost as compelling as your introduction to property lecture for your law students. When we last spoke, I asked you to get something to jot down a website, and if you're interested in supporting this event, which we certainly hope, you might visit toledoalumni.org, toledoalumni.org. The University of Toledo Alumni Association has college affiliates, and the College of Law is one of those affiliates. You visit that website and drill down through the law school affiliate page, and you'll be able to donate through the LaPalooza hyperlink. It's really easy, and your generous donations would be much appreciated. I thought it might be fun to share a couple of mementos from my days in law school. You know, we hold those school days to be cherished days in the so-called best times of our lives, undergraduate anyway, law school maybe not quite so much, but I have my diploma framed and in my office. Now, this is in a special place of honor for today's virtual LaPalooza. But the interesting thing about this is, one, I did in fact graduate from law school. And so if you're a judge watching this, you can take note of this. And despite my silly questions and antics sometimes in court, I did in fact graduate from law school. But right over here, we have the signature of John W. Stepler, Dean of the College, which is just kind of a fun thing to have around. And so, although Dean Stepler doesn't guide us physically today, the late Dean Stepler. He stays with us through the lessons that he taught us and even on the diplomas that he signed for us. So it's just kind of interesting. Another memento of my days in the law school, and you won't see this too many places, is this is the commemorative ashtray noting the College of Law being from 1906 through 1981. Now, I arrived in Toledo in the law school in the fall of 1982. This is a legit heavy piece. They don't make handouts and souvenirs like they used to, do they? The swag does not include the heavy glass ashtray anymore in this enlightened day that we live in. These also fly really well from the second floor balcony into the law school forum. And if you were there in the early 1980s, you'll remember that. So just a couple of little things to maybe liven up the show a little bit. We hope you're enjoying everybody's efforts in putting on this Lollapalooza event for you. We're back now with more Arctic Clam.
Coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. Gotta be down because I want it all. Started off with a kiss, how did it end up like this? It was only a kiss, it was only a kiss. Now we're falling asleep and she's calling a cab while he's having a smoke and she's taking a drag. And now they're going to bed and my stomach is sick and it's all in my head, but she's touching his chest. Now he takes off her dress. Now let me go. I just can't look. It's killing me. And taking control. Jealousy turning saints into the sea. Swimming through sick lullaby. Choking on your alibi, but it's just the price I bear. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes. I'm Mr. Brightside. Coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. Gotta be down because I want it all. Started off with a kiss and it ended up like this. It was only a kiss, it was only a kiss. Now he's falling asleep and she's calling a cab while he's having a smoke and she's taking a drag. And now they're going to bed and my stomach is sick and it's all in my head, but she's touching his chest. Now he takes off her dress. Now let me go. I just can't look. It's killing me and taking control. Jealousy turning saints into the sea. Swimming through sick lullaby. Choking on your alibi, but it's just the price I bear. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes. I'm Mr. Brightside.
Hey, pretty baby with the
high heels on now. You give me fever like I've never, never known. I'm just a part of your loveliness. I like the move of your walk, your talk, your dress. I feel your fever from a miles around. I'll pick you up in my car and we'll paint the town. So kiss me, baby, and tell me twice that you're the one for me. The way you're making me feel, you really turn me on. You knock me off of my feet now, darling. I like the thrill that you're giving me. So hold me, baby, and I'm in ecstasy. Oh, I'll be working from a 9 to 5 to buy you things just to keep you by my side. I never felt so in love before. So hold me, baby, love me forevermore. I'm trying to keep you satisfied. You're the one for me, the way you're making me feel. You really turn me on. You knock me off of my feet now, darling. Ooh, lonely days ago. A joke.
Our next message is from Charlotte Dymerkowski, who is the daughter of John Stepler, the namesake for our scholarship fund.
Welcome to La La Palooza 2020. I'm Charlotte Dymerkowski, and I am the youngest of John Stepler's 3 children, the eldest being John, and then Michael, and then myself. And we want to thank you so much for your participation in raising funds for the law scholarship that honors John's legacy. It's very important to us, of course, as family, that his legacy lives on. But even more, when I think of the law school and all the years that he was involved there and all that he has gone through and the law school, all the transformation and just the great place it is in today, I want to make sure that the legacy lives on, that more and more students are able to benefit from the scholarship and to take part in this great education at this great institution, the University of Toledo, and most particularly, the College of Law. Thank you.
Well, hello once again, and special thanks to Charlotte Dymerkowski for sharing her thoughts about Dean Stepler, her father, and the impact that the John W. Stepler Scholarship Fund can have on law students. When we last spoke, I encouraged you to visit toledoalumni.org to make a contribution. It occurs to me that not everyone would be as technologically savvy as I am and be able to negotiate a sophisticated website like ToledoAlumni.org. We encourage you to join the University of Toledo Alumni Association, and in particular, its law affiliate. You can do that in several ways. One way would be with a cash donation. Now, this is my wallet and how I keep my cash and my credit cards all together. I prefer a minimalist approach. And if you're having any difficulty thinking about what might be an appropriate donation, just consider everything about this Lollapalooza event and how it makes you feel. We appreciate your consideration. Thank you. If you don't happen to have cash and don't have the time to drive that over to Bancroft Street to deliver it to the law school, you could consider an object like this. Now, our younger alumni won't be familiar with this probably, but this is actually called a checkbook, and this is a paper check. It's an actual piece of paper, and by writing words and numbers upon that little piece of paper and affixing one signature, you can arrange to have money transferred to the John W. Stepler Scholarship Fund. You have to fill out the check and you have to put it in a paper envelope, and you take your tongue and moisten the gluey sticky side flap of that envelope and press it over, and it will seal this little piece of paper inside the envelope, and then you'll have it delivered to the University of Toledo College of Law through the constitutionally mandated United States Postal Service. And we know that's a reliable way to get your paper check over to the law school. Now, if you're not interested in any of these Luddite-like, old-fashioned methods, you can, of course, go to ToledoAlumni.org, drill down and make a payment with a credit card, whatever you feel comfortable with. The amount that you feel will help encourage the law student to be able to provide opportunities based on need and merit for Stepler Scholarship winners. Why would I want to contribute to something like this? Think about this. This is my one serious part of the whole speech event, and then I'll get back to my comedy. In this day and age when the rule of law is under daily attack by lay people, by lawyers, by elected officials, by those who would know better, how can we help strengthen the rule of law and what we as lawyers know is important for the appropriate functioning of our democratic republic? We could contribute to the law school, help train new people who will bring new insights and perspectives to the practice of law, and assist others in social justice and maintaining what we as lawyers know is the important framework that allows our society to continue to function. And it's under assault on a daily basis now. So that's why this is an important investment, in my humble opinion. To further that edification and understanding for you, now we'll hear from Walter Stargill, a past scholarship recipient. He'll share his story with you. I'll be back one more time. We're going to do a live remote shot, just like the evening news. It'll be very exciting. We'll see you soon.
My name is Walter Stargill, and I'm a 2017 recipient of the John W. Stepler Scholarship. When asked what I wanted to be when I grew up, the answer was always a Supreme Court justice. Reason being, in the third grade, I learned that a Supreme Court justice could not be fired. I guess you could say I truly knew the importance of employee benefits at a very young age. In choosing a law school, I put back on my third grade hat, and it came down to three factors: academics, accessibility, and longevity. The University of Toledo provided me with the academic rigor that I needed in order to build skills and confidence to perform as a lawyer. Accessibility was no different. Dean Barrows, the faculty, and the staff always had an open door policy for all students to come with concerns and anything else they wanted to discuss with the faculty. I too used this open door policy to bring not just lighthearted issues, but also hard issues. And as you know, we're dealing with a lot of hard issues at this time, and it is invaluable to have that open door policy and also an open ear policy. Now, you may be thinking that you can't contribute to the academics or the accessibility of the law school, but you can contribute to the longevity. By contributing to the John W. Stepler Scholarship Fund, you have an opportunity to provide future students the same opportunity that I received to accomplish their endeavors. Now, I may not be going after that Supreme Court justice seat anymore, but I do plan to practice within corporate law. With that, I thank you all for your contributions to the John W. Steffler Scholarship Fund, and make sure you remember to social distance.
Well, hello again. As you can see, I've made my way to the law school. There's not really anything going on here tonight, the night of Lollapalooza 2020, because we live in the age of the pandemic and everything's essentially virtual. So thank you for attending this Steffler Scholarship Fund raising event virtually. The University of Toledo College of Law alumni affiliate appreciate your support, and of course the Steffler family as well. It's hard to think of a better way to donate than to support the education and training of young lawyers and new lawyers. Your generous donations to that end through the Steffler Scholarship Fund are much appreciated. You can do that by going to ToledoAlumni.org and visiting the law affiliate and then making your generous donation. On behalf of the Law Alumni Association and the University of Toledo College of Law, we appreciate your support. Be lucky, stay healthy, and farewell. And to finish tonight's proceedings, I'll send it back to Nicole and Scott. This is Arctic Clam.
Snip inside the eye of your mind. Don't you know you might find a better place to play? You say that you've never been, but all the things that you've seen, they throw it all the way. Gonna start a revolution from my bed, 'cause the brain just said I had went to my head. Step outside, the summertime's in bloom. Stand up beside the fireplace, take that look from off your face, 'cause you ain't ever gonna burn my heart out. So Sally can wait, she knows it's too late as she's walking on back. So take me to the place where you go, where nobody if it's not a day. But please don't put your life in the hands of a rock and roll band, or throw it all away. Gonna start a revolution from my bed, 'cause the brains you said I had went to my head. Step outside, the summertime's in me. Stand up beside the fireplace, take that look from off your face. You ain't ever gonna burn my heart out. And so Sally can wait, she knows it's too late as she's walking on by. Thank you. 25 years on my life, and still I'm trying to get up that great big love hole for a destination. I realized quickly when I knew I should, the world was made up of this brotherhood of man, or whatever that means. And so I try sometimes when I'm lying in bed just to get it all out, what's in my head, and I'm feeling a little peculiar. And so I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath, get a real high, and I scream the top of my lungs, what's going on? And I said, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And I said, hey, what's going on? Ooh, 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 ooh. And I try, well, oh my God, do I try? I try all the time in this institution. And I pray, well, oh my God, do I pray? I pray every single day for evolution. I try sometimes when I'm lying in bed just to get it all out, what's in my head, and I'm feeling a little peculiar. And so I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath, get real high, and top of my lungs, what's going on? Hey, yeah, yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And I said, hey, yeah, yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And still, I'm trying to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination.
All right. Thank you.
is a burning thing. It makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flame got higher. And it burns, burns, burns. Ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire was wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flame got higher. And it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. Is a burning thing, it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire, and I fell into a burning ring of fire. Way down, 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 and the flame got high, and it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. Yeah, I fell into a burning ring of fire. Went down, 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 and the flame got higher. And it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. The ring of fire.
Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, with this feeling as faded as my dream. Yeah. Bobby thumbed the diesel down just before it rained. They rode us all the way to New Orleans. Well, I pulled my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. I was playing soft while Bobby sang the blue line. Windshield wipers slapping time, I was holding Bobby's head in mine. We sang every song that driver knew. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing, ain't nothing on if it ain't free. No, you know, feeling good was easy, Lord, when he sang the blue. You know, feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me and my Bobby and the kid. From the Kentucky coal mines to the California sun, yeah, Bobby shared the secrets of my soil. Through all kinds of weather, through everything that we've done, yeah, Bobby, coming from the cold world. One day up there, Salinas, Lord, let him slip away. He's looking up for that home, and I hope he finds it. Will I trade all of my tomorrows for one single yesterday, to be holding Bobby's body next to mine? Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing, and that's all that Bobby left. law for me, my baby, I'm gay. A la da da, a la da da, a la da da, da da da. La da da, la da, baby, I'm gay. La da da, la da, la da da da. La da da, la da, baby, I'm gay. Oh yeah, la da da.
Next and final message is from Kaylee Burton, Committee Chair of the LaPalooza Virtual Happy Hour. Thank you guys so much for having us. Thank you for tuning in, and we hope to see you next year.
Hi, everyone. I hope you're having a great time tonight. As committee chair, I just wanted to take a moment to thank my LaPalooza committee members for their time and efforts in making this event a success. I've planned several charitable events and fundraisers before, and I was so excited to help facilitate this scholarship this year. Then entered COVID-19. I have never planned a virtual fundraiser before, and I had absolutely no idea where to start. Although the pandemic threw us some curveballs this year, with the help of the committee members and Ansley and her staff, we were able to put together a program that was really great virtually. I also want to thank our alumni for their generous gifts and for tuning into this event today. This scholarship is not possible without your support. And with all of the uncertainties surrounding the COVID-19 pandemic, your gifts are more impactful than ever. If you haven't had a chance to donate yet, our crowdfunding page will be up and ready for your donations until September 30th, 2020. Just click the link below here to donate. Finally, I'd like to invite you to join the Law Alumni Affiliate if you're not a member already. Membership dues help facilitate scholarships such as this one, as well as networking opportunities and alumni activities. Keep an eye out for more information on our upcoming events. Our trivia nights in the recent past have been super successful, and we're very excited that we're going to be taking trivia night virtually. We don't have a whole lot of details yet, but keep an eye out for those and make sure to register as soon as possible, as virtual seating will be limited. Thank you so much again for joining us. Stay safe and stay healthy.